felt it first when I was younger. A strange connection to the light. I tried to satisfy the hunger. I never got it right. I never got it right. So I climbed a mountain and built an altar. Sammy Walter Kibagendi was born in Mosoveti village, which is now county of Nyamira, Tuesday 6th of February 1990. Growing up in the village was fun for this young boy. Although playful like any other child of his age, he also watched over his family's herds of cattle. Chasing after girls and listening to his grandma's nighttime stories would normally end his busy day. Coming from a teaching background, he accompanied his parents during their many travels, and this introduced him to many cultures at an early age. He spent part of his youthful years with the Kalenjin community where his mother comes from. Sammy was a loving person, incredibly nice. He smiled a lot and he worked hard in whatever his heart cherished.
From the time I've known him, he has a huge heart. Not physically, but you know what I mean. He's very funny. He works hard, like he pushes himself to the limit to achieve whatever he wants to do. And that is something I greatly admire in him, especially when it comes to class work and life as a whole.
He loves basically hanging out with people, so he's very, very social. He's someone who's very, very open. He actually tells you when he's wronged you or when you actually believe that you're wrong. Something else about him is that he's very determined. If he actually sticks to something, he will achieve it no matter what. He doesn't actually care what is going to stand in his way.
As a child, his dream was to be a pilot. The idea of flying above the clouds thrilled him. As he got into upper primary, he realized that his strength was in the languages and creative writing. For a while, he thought he was going to be a journalist. But the day he first held a camera, he immediately knew that his destiny was in creative storytelling through visuals.
He wanted to be a vet because he had this profound love for animals, especially dogs and, you know, cows. And then, at least when he was growing up, he developed an interest in writing and he thought he would pursue journalism in the university. But then again, he had some experience in filmmaking, you know, basic photography in his village, and this made him want to come and pursue filmmaking.
He went to Mosoveti Primary School and later joined TC School for his high school studies and stayed there for a year. He then joined Cardinal Otunga High School for 3 years and did an extra year at St. Teresa's High School in Rip. He had always been a storyteller. The camera was his favorite toy, and Multimedia University could give him the ability to tell his stories in a visual and accurate way.
He had been doing a lot of work, and he had been taking his work out there, you know, to people who have been established in the film industry. And through his work, his amazing work, he got a scholarship to study at Jamhuri Film and TV Academy along Ngong Road. It's been a blessing to him, you know, because it gave him an opportunity to finish what he'd loved doing, and that is filmmaking.
The school had a broad network into the Kenyan film industry, and he got to meet the right people that made his entry into the industry so smooth. Apart from producing a magazine at 17, Samora made a number of movies while at school.
He has had Selena, he has had Rosa, To Love is to Live, he's had Mrembo, Pinky. Saida is basically one that has actually been aired on Super Saturn on the Royal Media Services. He actually wrote the script and it's part of the shoot, the original shoot, but then actually it was given out to someone else. So that guy basically has achieved a lot. Very, very soon he's going to be probably producing even more that are going to be showcased on the major TV stations.
Sammy adored his mom and siblings. However, he had a rough relationship with his dad. He hated him, but as he grew older, he understood that whatever his dad had done was all because he wanted the best of him and from him. He is currently giving all his love and attention to building a career for himself, inculcating a filmmaking, film-watching culture among young people.
When it comes to editing, when it comes to photography, when it comes to all those things, I actually believe that he can actually get an award in actually each category. 3 years from now, he'll be having his own production house. He's actually going to be releasing so many movies, so many documentaries, and yeah, nurturing so many young people from his own place, and even Nairobi here, where basically he has been supporting so many guys like myself.
He has always believed that film is the only promising and powerful tool in social change. To Sammy, theater will always be his life, film his art, and television his furniture.
She asked the question.
Alikuwa
ashasema. Oh God, sawa. Fine.
Oh, God. Until the day that I die.